the details related with the zone, then seismic zones, then we will transfer to the ductility detailing of the structure. So the entire country is being divided in four seismic zones. Before or previously, before happening of the Latur earthquake, there were five zones, zone 1 to zone 5, and we people from Maharashtra were lying in zone 1. After this intraplate earthquake of Latur, this zone 1 has been terminated and we zone 1 people directly shifted to zone 2. Now, after watching this slide, it is very clearly means mentioned that the entire country is being divided in zone, mainly divided in zone 2 and zone 3. Zone 4 and zone 5 is a very small area. I don't know, maybe I am in fear that this zone 2 will also convert in zone 3. Or there is another question, the people who are living at the boundary of zone 2 and zone 3, the design is to be done by which specific code or by which specific zoning factor? Because the people who are living on the border, that border is not means likely Bharat-Pakistan border. You cannot say ki iske aage earthquake ka zone 2 hai aur iske aage earthquake ka zone 3 hai. So people who are means mentioning or who are thinking ki the ductile detailing code is not useful for zone 2, I think, or the provisions of the ductile detailing is not to be taken for zone 2 section. Now I think it has been cleared, we have to take care of ductility detailing although we are living in zone 2. Now what is mean by ductility? So ductility is nothing but the property of a material which can undergo a large deformation without failure or without rupture. So normally a chalk like material which is having a failure of brittle failure, but same time any rubber kind of material which will take a huge time to get damage or to get cut. So our structure is mainly constituent of steel as well as concrete. So it's a composite material. For sake of simplifying calculations, we assume it as a isotropic, homogeneous and all those things. But while designing these details, I think we should take care that the reinforcement required for this section would be placed at a proper location. It is not like this that somebody is placing more and more steel and saying my structure is now ductile structure. So the people who are again asking the question that after applying ductility detailing, my consumption of steel will get increased. It's not like this, never. Only the thing is that the current scenario of construction practices is like this. A ME structure or PhD person who is taking a lot of time to prepare the RCC details, to prepare the RCC calculation, and that all details and calculations are being checked or verified by a mistri who is a completely layman. And simply he will say, Saab, ye design bahut heavy hai. Because due to you have provided a lot of details related with stirrups, related with bar bending and all those things, your design will seems to be like this, like a heavy design. At the end of the day, if you go with the ductility detailing structure and non-ductile detailing structure, I don't think there is a massive change. But this is the scenario that every time your drawing is to be judged by a person who is a completely layman. More or less builder or owner of the house tries to understand the feeling of that contractor rather than to understand the working of the engineer. So this is, I think, a real scenario, and this is really need to be changed. So I was there that if we are providing more and more steel, our structure will not be a ductile structure. Steel should be placed at its proper location. That is called we are providing a proper detailing for the ductility, and that is only the I think main motto of this particular code. So this is a very simplified sketch I have shown here. After preparing this ductility detailing, and if that has been implemented by the contractor on site, my structure will safe and sound. Same time, if I don't use such kind of detailing, there may be a scope of brittle failure or collapse. So this is very a simplified version with the help of ductile and brittle material stress strain graph. Now, coming towards the main motto of this session, that we need to check the possibilities of the code which can be really useful to implement in zone 2 and zone 3 strictly. Nowadays, in current scenario of construction practices, the detailing is a major part and is not being followed by the contractor. If we all designer, architects and contractors tries to implement all those detailing to be done on site, I think the main motto of this particular session will get satisfied. So scope of 13920 is related to providing the ductility details, why it is required, general specification of the code, provisions for beam, column and inclined head member, then newly introduced part, that is beam column joint of moment resisting frame, special shear walls, gravity columns. I have not covered this gravity column in this presentation, and some of my real site drawings and detailing I am going to present in this topic. Now, ductility gives a notice to the occupant and provides sufficient time to taking the preventive measures. This will reduce the loss of life and properties. Because while failure of the structure, the ductile structure will take a sufficient time to at least evacuate the livings. At least. I'm not saying that it will not fail, because our philosophy of earthquake design is not like this. Then ductile detailing is provided in structure so as to give them adequate toughness. Yes, of course, the toughness of the structure is required. Only ductile structure is not required. Toughness with the ductility. In case of RCC members, as I have previously told, that in the lateral loading condition, there will be some inelastic deformations. Due to that, the failure may occur, and that's why ductility plays a vital role in the design. Now, why this ductility is really required? When the structure undergoes in dynamic forces, it could not remain in elastic anymore. So, to become structure more elastic, we provide the ductility detailing. It goes through plastic stage or fracture when stiffness decreases appreciably and deformation increases drastically even for small load. This situation must be expected by engineer, and we should ensure that our design sustain the loads without undergoing large deformation, or it should not lead to any collapse. So this is the main requirement why ductility is required. Again, the same question will be asked, that in zone 2 really it is required. I'll say no, it is not required, but still, if we can implement this detailing, it will increase the life of structure. It will help to make more durable structure, because right now in Marathwada region, what I have seen up till now, people are not aware, although related with the cover. We have to ask people to provide 50 mm cover to footing. He will try to use some stone chips below footing and he will say, you, sir, cover lavlela ahe. So in this particular scenario, we have to literate people, we have to ask people to go for such kind of detailing. In steel structure, such kind of brittleness is never been seen, because steel is a particularly single kind of material and whose behavior is completely ductile behavior. So in steel structure, it is really not necessary to use such kind of ductility detailing. In case of any joints and all those things, maybe some special cases, anybody can check such kind of detailing. But again, there is some another code related to see all those details. But in this particular code, only RCC is covered. Now, this is the graph by which we can elaborate properly what is happening with the ductile structure and what is happening with the brittle structure. If you see this deformation versus force graph, you will realize that brittle material is get fail before starting of its yielding. Same time, the ductile material fail at its So, this ductility will offer you a great time to either repair the structure or to evacuate from this structure if it is going to be collapsed. Now, the scope of this code is designing and detailing of RCC member to resist lateral effect of earthquake shaking. While calculating the earthquake forces, there is a very simplified empirical formula which is used for calculation of horizontal base shear coefficient, AH. So this AH is equal to Z by 2 into I by R into SA by G. We all know this. The code IS 1893-2016 provides the empirical formula for calculating this horizontal seismic coefficient of earthquake. So in this, the parameter Z is nothing but your zone factor. Parameter R is your response reduction factor. I is importance factor, and SA by is the acceleration coefficient. So while calculating this base shear, the value of AH will be get reduced if I use special ductile frame. If I use SMRF, special moment resisting frame, I can take value of R is equal to 5. Whereas if I am going to use IS-456 only, I have to take the value of R is equal to 3. Now, if I go with the calculation of value of AH, you will find that if I use more value of R or larger value of R, I'll get lesser value of AH. So this is the first benefit if I use ductile detailing or use a special moment resisting frame in RCC, the earthquake forces is going to be reduced. And if the earthquake forces is going to be reduced, ultimately my entire moment on the columns will also get reduced, which will result the lesser quantity of reinforcement as well as some kind of relaxation in cross-sectional area of column also. So, scope of work of this code is the provisions for RC moment resisting frame, the provision for RC moment resisting frame using without unreinforced masonry infill wall, RC resisting frames with RCC structure wall, and independent RCC wall structure. So RCC walls means shear wall. So such kind of detailing related to these structural elements is being provided or is being made a provision for the ductile detailing. Now, for the bridges, piers, different kind of foundations and all those, only general concept of this code can be adopted. Otherwise, for bridges and special kind of structure, you have to refer some kind of IRC, or for railway and all those things, their own department literature or code are been available. So this code can be used only for in general purpose for the basic concept for the special kind of structures. So provision for RCC structure located in seismic zone 3, 4, 5, option in 2, as I have previously stated. This can be adopted for the precast structure because right now in metro cities, such kind of precast shear wall structures are being proposed by many of the builders and many of the construction companies. So if such kind of precast structure is being used and its joints are kept as a monolithic joint, they have made, if they have made a proper provision for the joints and all those things, then this code can be used for their design purposes. Or otherwise, there are some another codes like 11447, I think 15690. These are the codes which can be used for such kind of RC wall construction. So all RCC frame, all RCC walls and their element structure need not to be designed to resist lateral load. Again, this is a part of choice of a designer. If he can sort out around 90% of the elements in his analysis file, which can resist the lateral forces up to 90%, then remaining part or remaining structural element can be designed and only gravity elements. So that gravity column is now being introduced in this code. Previous code, it was not been introduced. So small kind of structure, I don't think this is really implemented, but for a bigger scale of structure, this will be a choice of designer, which kind of element he or she wants to kept as a lateral load resisting system, and remaining part it can be kept as a gravity load system only. Now the basic change which is really necessary in our region and now imposed by code, and I really appreciate this clause, that minimum grade of concrete is now M20 for any kind of structure, but M25 for zone 3 and 4. So if it is more than 15 meter height, you have to go for M25. I means always ask such kind of things to my client also, why we are not means proposing higher grade of concrete in Marathwada region. I don't know, many of the my colleagues maybe use such kind of higher grade of concrete, but what I have seen in general right now, people are not shifting from M15 to M20. Means अभी भी साइट पे अगर हमको पूछा जाए तो द डेपो इज अराउंड 12 टोपले रहती 14 टोपले खड़ी लाइक दिस. सो आई थिंक प्रॉपर ग्रेड ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट इज टू बी मेंटेन ऑन साइट, एंड इफ इट इज रियली मेंटेन आई थिंक वी विल हेल्प टू मेक स्ट्रक्चर्स मोर ड्यूरेबल. सी गिरता कुछ भी नहीं है, लेकिन अगर टिकाना है इसको तो हमको ड्यूरेबिलिटी की तरफ बात करनी पड़ेगी. एंड नाउ कोड हैज इंप्लीमेंटेड दिस मिनिमम ग्रेड दैट वी शुड गो फॉर M20, एंड फॉर हायर जोन्स वी शुड गो फॉर M25 एज ए मिनिमम ग्रेड. अगेन दिस कोड इज नॉट अ मींस सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर IS 456. वी हैव टू रेफर 456 एज इट इज. While using 456, these are some kind of special detailing which can be used and structure more durable. Now, up till now, we people were using Fe415 tor steel. Right now, we people are using Fe500 in Jalna. Now, Fe550 is also means the people are manufacturing. So I think higher grade of steel is also required. I think this is the means requirement of the time, that we are going to higher grade of concrete, so we should go for higher grade of steel also. But same time, code suggests that its proof strength should not be more than should not be less than 40%. So 14, 1-4. So that I think manufacturer will take care how to means keep this elongation or ductility of the reinforcement steel as it is, and they will provide us, I assure. So 550 is also introduced with this, Fe550 is also introduced with this code. Again, I have told you the ratio of ultimate strength, so it will maintain. Now, factored axial compressive stress would be 8%. Means your compressive stress of the means coming on the columns or any kind of member. Compressive stress in the beam element or any kind of element which can resist biaxial bending plus axial force. Now the code has given a criteria. Previously, or IS 456, there is 0.2 FCK, means there was around 2% of load carrying capacity we have imposed on a beam element, and now it has been reduced to 0.8%. So why this? To make a proper difference between beam and column. Again, the B by D ratio is kept as 0.3 or then minimum dimension of the beam is kept as 200 mm. So in our region, 150 mm is also means very great choice of architects and many of the people ki khatki nako disayla room madhe. So this is I think one of the hurdle that people will oppose this, that we will not accept 150 or 200 mm minimum dimension. But very frankly speaking, for the mm cross section of beam, the reinforcement placement is very horrible. One cannot imagine how the people or that fitter is placing the reinforcement. So if you are going to provide 30 mm cover minimum, I am talking about minimum cover. So 30 is 60 mm, and then after, if you are using a 12 mm dia bar as a top reinforcement or top anchor bar, so 12 and 12 is 24 mm plus 60, it around 85 mm we have covered for the reinforcement and cover. Now how the concrete will get placed in that cross section, because around 70 mm size we have remained to pour the concrete. So in my opinion, we people should minimum take 230 mm width of beam, so that to accommodate a proper reinforcement in the beam. Because as a beam designer, now it is the responsibility imposed by government of Maharashtra or government of India that the structure should remain as it is. Or in RERA also, the responsibility of structural engineer is too much. So to avoid that responsibilities and bad working practices on site, we all people should go with the minimum width of the member specified by IS 13920. I'll really ask you all people to provide 230 mm beam depth, beam width, so that it will be ease in construction also. The last is clear span by 4, not for beam of ESR. So the deep beam are being avoided by this code. If you are providing deep beam, so go with some another code, maybe in 456, all those details related to deep beam are being covered. But in this particular code, the deep beam details or details related with the deep beam is not been covered. One may ask the question, why the deep beam are not to be covered in this particular code? So definitely the answer is there. The main, main motto of this code is the entire design will be done so as your column will be more stronger and beam will be lesser stronger. So the next slide we will discuss that philosophy also. So first time it is acknowledged that the width of beam may be wider than the column. And again, previously I have discussed related to conjunction of the reinforcement in the junction. So all the conjunction of reinforcement, we will have a scope to get reduced at the junction of the beam and column. See, while we are working with the larger span of beams, say 8 meter, 8 meter, 10 meters and so, and if we are not means approaching for the PET technology, then same time you will require a beam depth around say 600, 750 or so. Same time we have to take a width of say 380 or 450. But same time the width of column we cannot take like this. Otherwise again your design will get heavy by so-called contractor and so-called people will ask, "Arey sir, itna bada column rehta hai kya kahin?" So I think this may be useful in that scenario also to means we can provide a smaller size or lesser size of the column, and same time as the requirement of the beam, the width of the beam can be get increased. Now some of the glimpse of the provision of beam elements required for the ductility detailing, and you people also might be agree with me that yes, these details are can be easily implemented on site. What it says that you should keep two numbers of 12 mm dia bar at top and two numbers of 12 mm dia bar at bottom. So in my opinion, right now we people provide anchor steel as 8 mm. Or some of the people may provide this anchor steel as a 10 mm. So I don't think that there is a huge weight difference between these two type of reinforcement bars. Means if we are using 12 mm and if you are using 10 mm bar, of course bottom steel is to be provided by your bending moment requirement, no doubt. But for top steel, if we can go for 12 hash bars, it will definitely help for detailing. It will definitely help for proper working on site. If I use 8 mm dia bars, you will find that on site these bars will get bent while people are walking on it. Top steel, all top steel related to slab is resting on beam top surface, and while people are walking from here and there because electrical fitting hota hai uske baad aur फॉल सीलिंग से रिलेटेड कुछ लटकाना होता है, ये है वो है, तो ये सारी चीजों में टॉप के जो बार होते हैं वो सारे के सारे बार दब जाते हैं. सो इफ वी कैन यूज दिस 12 एम एम डाया बार्स, आई डोंट थिंक दैट देयर इज ए मीन्स मैसिव चेंज इन रिएनफोर्समेंट रिक्वायरमेंट. जर 8 एम एम चे बार घेतले तर इट विल वेट अराउंड 400 ग्राम पर मीटर, बट सेम टाइम इफ आई यूजिंग 12 एम एम बार इट विल वेट अराउंड 900 gram per running meter. So around 500 gram per running meter is the weight difference. So in a simple building, I won't means in a small house rather, I won't think that more than 300 running meter beam will require. So if you calculate the weight related with means 12 mm dia bar and weight related with 8 mm dia bar, I won't think that a big or huge difference will be there. Now, minimum longitudinal steel ratio at any phase is kept as 0.24 under root FCK upon FY. So, really speaking, if you go for M20 and Fe500, you will require only 200 mm square steel, which is being provided by your 12 mm dia bars already. So the clause has been satisfied. Now, in IS 456, the reinforcement, maximum reinforcement was allowed around 4%. Now, here, the maximum reinforcement allowed for the beam section is only 2.25%. Instead of 4%, we are going for 2.5%, sorry. So this will show, yes, after providing ductility detailing, our lateral forces are being reduced, and same time the maximum percentage ratio is reduced. Code is not allowing you to provide means 4% of steel in beam. Again, this is always a conflict between contractor, means your reinforcement binder, and the structural engineers to bend the top and bottom reinforcement in column section. In previous code, it was shown something different, but now it is very clear. You can use only this bar bent up to beam depth. Although it is written as the x value mark in the section, this x value mark in the section as a development length, but this development length will definitely get achieved if I use a 300 mm wide section of column and 600 mm wide section of the column and 600 mm itself a wide depth of the beam. So for a diameter of 20 mm, I'll require say 50 times of diameter. Development length is around 1 meter. So that 1 meter development length can be easily achieved by your beam width of 600 and column width of 600 and column beam depth of 600. So that particular depth of 1 meter can be easily achieved. So this also can be implemented easily in our region, because for the larger span of beams, we people never release the movement at the support. And yes, of course, code also state that if the lateral load resisting members are there, you cannot redistribute any moment by any percent. Whereas 456 allow you to redistribute of the moment around 30%. But at the same time, ductility detailing code doesn't allow you to provide any kind of redistribution of moment. If we are not redistributing moment, then such kind of detailing is to be followed. And if such kind of detailing is to be followed, I think we are using this ductility code. The implementation is already been started. Likewise, the another part, the another next clause is you have to keep at least one fourth of the total area of reinforcement at the bottom face at the junction. This is for the reversible stresses due to earthquake. And what I feel strongly that you need not to follow this code, because this has been already followed by you people. If I am going to provide, say, 1000 mm square area at the top, same time, I'll try, means 1000 area, how, say, I am using 20 hash 3 number bars. So around 900 or so, or 1000 mm square area has been covered at the top face of the column at the junction. Same time, I'll try to provide 2 numbers of 20 dia bars at the bottom face. So while using top steel as a 900 or 1000 mm square, same time for such a beam, I'm going to use around 50% of steel at the bottom face. So frankly speaking, many of the clauses are being followed by we people already. So it's not means like this ki ye ab nayi cheez hai hum kaise isko adopt karenge, except the thing 12 mm ke do bar top aur 12 mm ke do bar bottom, and the next things related with the confining reinforcement and ring shapes. I don't think that such thing is to be hurdle to use on site. Now there are some means clauses been proposed by the code related with the splicing of the reinforcement. For the small span elements, for the beams and all those things, the splicing is really not means required at a floor level. Mainly we people use this splicing for columns, because we have to go for floor by floor. Same time, if I am using a complete slab and the span is around 8 meter, 9 meter, 12 meter is the available length of bar, and I can directly use that 12 meter length of bar for the large span beam also. But still, if somebody wants to use such kind of splicing in the reinforcement, code has suggested the things. And again, you all people will agree with this, where there is a joint of two reinforcement bar, we should provide a proper close stirrup spacing so that it will not break at all, because wahi tutne jaisi jagah hai jahan se structure break ho sakta hai. So break ho sakta hai, isliye wahan pe close reinforcement chahiye. I think nobody will deny this. Then the lap length shall not be less than of development length, means jab hum lapping kar rahe hain to the lap length is to be followed. If I am using 20 mm dia bar, then I have to use that 50 times of diameter lap length. Again, this is a thumb rule, 50 times of diameter. Actual development you can calculate by using IS 456. The proper provision and calculation details have been asked by code. Now, not more than 50% area of steel to be spliced at one location. Yes, this is to be again agree that we should not use 50% more than 50% of the bar splice at one location. आई थिंक आवर कॉन्ट्रेक्टर एंड फिटर विल ऑल्सो एग्री विद दिस कि हमको सारे बार एक ही जगह पे कट नहीं करने हैं. When the such kind of lapping is to be avoided, where there is a joint of primary and secondary member, or I will not say like this primary or secondary, I will say one beam or another, you cannot provide the lap joint within the distance of 2D from the face of column. Yes, there is not necessary that at the support location we should provide the such kind of means lapping. Within a quarter length of the beam adjoining to the location where flexural yielding may occur under the earthquake effect, and not more than 50% of the area, we have already discussed this. In column, there is a choice of means contractor that the splicing should be done at the floor level. But this is not a right region to provide the splicing. Although one may ask the question, because due to providing such kind of splicing at the floor level, the reinforcement due to lapping, the area of reinforcement may get increased. Yes, may get increased. But there is no scope of proper binding of reinforcement or proper placing of reinforcement. People are just placing the bars, I means horrible type. So that is to be avoided. And if we can provide the column splicing in this particular region, then it will be useful for providing a proper jointing process. Check all the details whether they have provided by the fitter are in a right manner or not. And in case of, if we are using mechanical couplers, we cannot provide the joints of the reinforcement at the floor level, because there is no scope to check whether the coupler is fitted rightly or not. That's why we people should try to make this splice of column reinforcement in the middle part, means some part from floor above and some part from below your roof. Now code has specially marked this splicing related to welding. I personally don't believe on the welding done on RCC site, because I'm afraid, because people, how they are going to welding all those things really means unimaginable. So I will not means ask you also to suggest such kind of splicing on site. But same time, we people are using such kind of mechanical couplers at our many site locations. In Aurangabad also, Jalna Road, there is one site, and we are using such kind of mechanical couplers there. So for beam, for column, for both of the elements, we are using such kind of couplers. The benefit of these couplers is that there will be no conjunction of reinforcement at the junction of splicing. There will be old bar and new bar, so there will be a large conjunction. So due to using of this coupler, your conjunction of reinforcement will get closed. So working will be easy, because concreting, while doing concreting, there will be a ease of working. And if the material is in a purchased or prepared in a proper way, there would be a assurity of quality also. Now again, this is a important part of code, that the special kind of transverse reinforcement, or say confining reinforcement, used or stated by this code and how to be implemented on site. So for larger span, there is always we people provide 8 mm dia bar or 10 mm dia bar or 12 mm dia bar. But for smaller span, we people never prefer such kind of rings. Even for 8 mm dia bar, there is means बहुत सारा लफड़ा है कि आप 8 mm का बार भी रिंग के लिए नहीं दे पाते साइट पे. अगर आप देते हैं तो आपको फिर कॉन्ट्रैक्टर या फिर फिटर फोन करेगा, सर ये 8 mm के बार आपने रिंग को दे दिए, ये तो रिंग मारना ही नहीं पॉसिबल. बट व्हाई आई थिंक दिस 8 mm इज बीन इम्पोज्ड बाय कोड इज अगेन फॉर द ड्यूरेबिलिटी ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर. इफ द 6 mm डाया बार गेट इरोड बाय एनी ऑफ द वे and if it is been eroded by say 1 mm, so the effective area of diameter of bar will around only 4 mm. Now please tell me whether this 4 mm bar is really will work in a case or in a situation of earthquake or lateral loading or durability. No. So we all people should now impose this 8 mm dia bar to the people, because we are the practitioners. If we can suggest such kind of positive changes to the people who are working with us, I think we people help to generate or say manufacture or say build durable structures. So 8 mm link or 8 mm stirrups is to be used, or minimum diameter of the bar is 8 mm for beam stirrups. Again, the calculation related with the shear force capacity for beam and all those things, so I'll not go into that. I'll just this is the part which is really contributed in the calculation of shear reinforcement. So in previous code, there were a provision to take the capacity of bent up steel also while calculating the shear reinforcement. In this code, that bent up bar contribution of shear reinforcement or shear resisting force is being totally ignored. Inclined link are now being banned. Previously, that inclined stirrup calculation is also available. Was also available in some of book, and code was also stating for the inclined head stirrup. But now this inclined head stirrup should totally be banned or obsolete. The contribution of RCC section for shear resisting is now been absolute. Use of close spacing of links. Yes, you people will also agree me that shear force is more at the support and less at the mid span of the beam in case of a beam carrying with a UDL. So in that case, only the spacing they have provided, that is the only part where aap aur contractor jhagda kar sakte hain. They have spaced the reinforcement very closely. That is only the thing. Now this is the figure number 6 of IS 13920. In this particular section, all those whatever discussed right now up till now is been implemented with this figure. So in that they have stated that at the junction of beam and column, from 50 mm you have to start the first link. Our first stirrup would be from 50 mm from the face of column. It will take some time to literate the people, but hopefully if we provide such kind of detailing on the site, definitely people will try to implement it on site. So minimum 2 bars are required. 50 mm is the minimum spacing between the junction of beam and column, and from that you have to go for the spacing. So minimum of D by 4 8 dB and 100 mm. So 100 mm is the minimum spacing which we have to provide at the support of the beam. So in case of beam stirrups, these are the hooks being provided by IS code very specifically. Previously it was 75 mm, now it is 65 mm only. In case of pre-stress beam, we have to provide a U-shaped bar like this, and the cross tie is to be provided like this. So while using pre-stress beam, if we are using the details like this, we have to go with such kind of detailing. So I don't think that such kind of detailing may not be possible on site. Yes, easily possible, and we can implement this. Again, these are the some of the required detailing provided by the code to form a proper reinforcement ties or links. In this, the gap between two bars of the column, this gap between or the dimension between two reinforcement bar of the column is not being exceeded than 300 mm. I think this is also useful criteria code has prescribed. In the failure of column, we people have seen there is always failure of links, not a mean reinforcement, because mean reinforcement of the column will get buckle. Concrete getting crushed, the main reinforcement will get buckle. But same time, at the buckling location, the tie will get fail in tension. So more are the ties provided in the column, will become more safer the column. Now, provisions for column and inclined elements. Again, 0.8% FCK, 0.8 FCK, more than 0.8 FCK is the compressive stress, your element will be called as a column. Then, factored axial compression stress, compressive stress considering load column, load combinations related to seismic load shall be limited to 0.4 FCK. Yes, in short, actually loaded column, we people use such formula only. So I don't think that there is something different the code has been implemented. But due to providing this criteria, we will provide larger size of columns, or we will go for higher grade of concrete. If we are going to higher grade of concrete, definitely our cross section will get reduced. Or if we are going higher cross sections, our reinforcement will get reduced, because ultimately we are providing the percentage of steel in accordance with the cross sections. Now at every corner we have to put 12 mm dia bar, at least minimum. So for T-shape and X-shape column, appropriate design and detailing is to be followed. Yes, we will follow, and I will show one of my case in which such kind of columns are being used. So this is the one or two are a little bit critical clauses placed by the code, that if we are using 20 mm dia bar, we have to go for 400 mm width of column. I don't think this is really possible in our region, but can be implemented as required. But minimum width of the column will remain 300 mm. I think this is also very useful criteria being implemented by or imposed by code. In Aurangabad itself, if we see buildings which are say parking plus 4 or parking plus 5 floors, you will see that the columns taken as 230 mm width. I personally feel that if we are using P plus 5 or P plus 3, so sorry for the interruption. So minimum diameter dimension of the column or minimum width of the column is to be kept as 300 mm. I personally feel that while we are designing a building using parking floor, it will act like a reverse kind of pendulum. So in that case, we should go with the width of minimum width of 300 mm dimension of the columns. Ratio of smaller dimension to the larger dimension, width to beam, width to depth ratio has been implemented by us code, and that is shall not less than 0.4, so that our column will not like this 230 by 1000 mm, 230 by 1200 mm, like this. So the column itself will have more sturdy, and that's why they have implemented this ratio. So less axial stress ratio will result in a lesser percentage of reinforcement demand, even if the higher bending stress, and will improve the behavior of the structure. Now, in this code, this particular philosophy has been used, that your structure, if get failed, it would fail at the part of beam location, not at the part of column location. Because if the column is going to be fail, the structure will fail in a fraction of a second, because it is a shear failure. But while the beam will fail, it will take a lot of time to get failed. Flexural failure if there. So this is the main criteria, and I think this is the main hurdle also to implement such kind of detailing on site. Because every time drawing का पहला हिस्सा माने कॉलम फुटिंग साइड पे रिलीज होते ही वो हेवी है या लाइट है, ये कॉन्ट्रैक्टर और फिटर डिक्लेयर करता है. तो जस्ट बाय सीइंग द कॉलम फुटिंग डिटेल्स, आई डोंट नो हाउ दे पीपल जज ऑल दोस थिंग्स, बट स्टिल इफ आई प्रोवाइड अ प्रॉपर क्रॉस सेक्शनल डिटेल्स ऑफ द कॉलम एंड प्रोवाइड द डिटेल्स ऑन साइट, definitely I got the message from site, sir ye bahut heavy ho gaya na, thoda samay lagega logo ko isme aane ke liye, lekin iske liye hum sabko kuch na kuch pehel karni chahiye. Now these are the stirrups which are been means code suggests that you should provide such kind of links such kind of ties for the stirrups. Now, this is the typical cross-section provided by IS code, which gives the proper detailing related with the splicing zone, related with the junction of the beam and column. And frankly speaking, what this is, they just want a proper reinforcement. Shear reinforcement is to be provided on the column, on the structural element. Now, these are the some calculation part related to means beam and column joints. I think these all things are being taken care of by software like ETAB and STAD. So to discuss all those technical or mathematical terminologies here is not been really necessary. So I'll just means ignore this part. So special confining reinforcement already we have discussed, that is means already marked in this section. We have to just follow that section. I think many of the thing will be definitely been achieved specified by the code. Now shear wall are been introduced with this code, and I think in Marathwada region also many of the people now turning with the construction of shear wall. In Aurangabad also many buildings by using shear wall is been means on the way of construction. So while providing shear walls, there is always a question that वो बहुत एरिया लगता है शियर वॉल के लिए, कॉन्क्रीट का एरिया या कॉन्क्रीट का कंजम्पशन बहुत होता है. सेम टाइम इफ वी आर गोइंग और इफ वी आर यूजिंग 150 mm थिकनेस ऑफ विड्थ ऑफ वॉल, आई डोंट थिंक दैट अ ह्यूज डिफरेंस और मैसिव डिफरेंस विल बी देयर. सेम टाइम इफ देयर इज अ बिल्डिंग ऑफ से जी प्लस 8 और जी प्लस 7 एंड इफ वी आर गोइंग टू यूज सच काइंड ऑफ शियर वॉल्स, I'll say your functional requirement will be get satisfied. कहीं पे भी खटकी नहीं आएगी, because you will provide a larger length of the walls, तो खटकी आने का कोई सवाल नहीं रहेगा. So it will give a good aesthetic appearance. At same time, the reinforcement will also get reduced, because if I am using less than 0.28 fck of the compressive stress, I can ask this element as a shear wall element. So for such kind of shear walls, the percentage of reinforcement required is very far less than your column and all those things. So if such kind of walls is been implemented, definitely will increase the lateral load resisting power or capacity of the section. And detailing is not a big deal of this shear walls, because we people always use such kind of reinforcement or such kind of detailing in our regular RC walls in our regular buildings for lift well. So nothing special. So this kind of special shear wall here I have mentioned, that is including your tie element and without tie element also. So in our region, I don't think that such kind of tie element is being useful. Yes, without tie element, we can go for the shear walls. So 150 mm is the minimum thickness which code suggests for the shear walls, and we can also easily implement such kind of thickness in the our regular practice. So these are the kind of walls presented or asked by a code: squat wall, intermediate wall, slender wall. I don't think that there is a means big mathematical issues related with calculation and detailing. अभी कैसा होगा? I think by referring code and clauses, and same time by using ETAB kind of software, which will give the entire detailing and designs for the shear walls. So this is again the provision of reinforcement provided by the IS code in table number 1 of IS 13920. these are the means reinforcement detail required, but I think the the reinforcement whatever we are providing, it has at 150 center to center on both the faces, in two curtains, both the faces or in two curtains, that will fulfill your requirement. Boundary element, if you want, you can provide. If you don't want, you cannot. Means this, it's not means necessarily required to provide the boundary elements unless and otherwise your stress factor get increased. But frankly speaking, in my practice, whatever I seen, for a regular building, if I am going to provide the such kind of walls of say 1.8 meter length, 1.5 meter length, that will suffice everything. Now these are the some of the major changes that is related with the column dimension, beam dimension, then column to beam strength ratio, then your confining reinforcement, anchorage details, splicing. So this was the summary related to that. Now I am going to the concluding part of my presentation. See, on the left hand side of the slide, I have shown two structures. ये भी टिकते हैं और ये भी चलते हैं. And same time, in the right side, I have shown a very nice building. I have taken this photograph from internet. But see, the designer has provided all his best to do the calculation, to do the detailing for such kind of project. Same time, on the left hand side, there I don't think there is a engineer or a literate person to implement the things. So my vision, my perspective, or my request to all of us is, we will go for right hand side view. So that in Marathwada region, or I will say in our Maharashtra, such kind of structure will be appear, and definitely the designer will be again among all of us. These are some of our projects in which we are using already such kind of detailing. The uppermost picture is related with builder scheme. That has been means construction is on progress at Jalta. This is one of the apartment building at the bottom side where we are implementing all those detailing, and this is the apartment building at Satara side. Then Kranti Chowk, the statue of Shivaji Maharaj, the base structure is been means designed by us, and same kind of detailing is been adopted for this structure also. Apart from these RCC structures, we people design steel structure also. Right now, the pictures, whatever you are seeing, that is bottom side picture is for Rajuri SMS plant, steel melting shed. And the upper one is at Pune, that is Bhuleshwar Steel and Alloy. So this is our main and core business, steel structure and detailing and designing for Jalna and remaining part of India for design and implementing. Now these are the references and sources. I will take again 5 minutes or of you to just show some of CAD drawings.
अरे मेरे पास केमिस्ट्री की सॉल्व हुई है, बाकी की अभी कर रहा हूँ मैं तुरंत, तो अभी डाउनलोड करके पीडीएफ फाइल तो करके भेज रहा हूँ.
So these are the means kind of ductility detailing sheet we provide on the site, in which we provide the details of beam, how the stirrup will be placed, how the junction will be placed. Likewise, these are some of the means details of column and their stirrups. What we are going to provide on the sides. Same time, one of the case from Delhi University is there, in which we have provided models and different kind of different kind of shapes in the column. So I'll just show you how the reinforcement is being placed in the walls. These are the walls. Then these are the columns. See, the size of column is around 450 mm by 600 mm. And the reinforcement is placed like this. The stirrups also, you can see the kind of stirrup the designer has been adopted. This is not my project. Then this is also some kind of shapes, different kind of shapes being adopted by the designer, because this is an institutional building at Delhi. So here, this project was for us for proof checking. These kind of stirrups. So
hello sir,
thank you very much friends. This is our team, and without the help of this team I cannot do anything. So a special thanks from them also and from me also. Thank you, ACC Limited.
Thank you, Engineer Ravindra Bansode sir. Now I request Engineer Muin Khan sir to take us to question answer session. Khan sir.
Once again, good afternoon. I think there were some issues, sir, in the last 2-3 projects which you were, you know, showing. People are not able to see the videos. I mean, or whatever the screen. So it was only your voice was visible. But anyway, I think we have gone through a very informative session, and I thanks to all the participants for their careful listening and, you know, for their interest in the subject. And also, above all, Engineer Bansode Saab, that he has given such a, you know, insight and a very detailed lecture. So there are limitations on the online. We all know that 1 hour is the maximum limit. Generally, the lectures हमारे होते हैं उसमें 1 hour के बाद में we feel that we should have a more discussion, you know. So I think we will take some questions, Bansode Saab.
Yes, please.
Yeah. So the first question which is coming from Guru Shankar Ji, he says that what is the maximum ultimate strength to the 0.2% proof stress of steel?
Maximum
ultimate strength.
That is 500 Newton per mm square.
To the 0.2% proof stress of steel. So that is 500. Sir, you will, okay, one two people, they want the presentation as always. So I think that is the call of Bansode Saab. If we share the presentation with us, we will definitely share with you all. Mr. Sunil Patil says that Ravin sir, you have mentioned regarding use of higher grade concrete like M25, 30, etc. in Marathwada. But is it really possible to manufacture the higher grade concrete to its requirement on each and every site in absence of RMC plant?
Yes, definitely, sir. This is a very right question he has asked. See, always there is a question that how to prepare a higher grade of concrete on site. Sir, अभी है ना बहुत अच्छे mixer आने लग गए हैं जो mixer को वे बैचर inbuilt है. वे बैचर बोलने से अच्छा उसको एक उन्होंने weighing scale का एक क्या बोलते हैं एक एलिमेंट ऐड कर दिया है केवल होपर को. तो आप जो भी रेती खड़ी उसमें डालते हैं ना वो आपको स्क्रीन पे दिखता है. एक छोटा स्क्रीन भी उसके साथ अटैच करके दिया है. द सेम काइंड ऑफ मिक्सर इज बीन यूज्ड एट जालना रोड यशोदीप होटल के बिल्कुल बाजू में हम लोग वो मिक्सर यूज कर रहे हैं. एंड वी आर मीन्स मेकिंग दिस M35 ग्रेड कॉन्क्रीट ऑन साइट इटसेल्फ रादर देन यूजिंग RMC. So now by the use of technology in an economical way, we can produce this M35 grade concrete on site. Definitely you have to prepare this mix design from authentic people or authentic agency.
Yeah. And I'd like to add one more point in this, sir. Nowadays the cement which is available in the trade market, so particularly SCC is manufacturing Concrete Plus. SCC Concrete Plus, basically that is a very high grade cement. And despite of being a PPC, it you can compare it its strength features of 1 day, 3 day, 7 day, 28 day with OPC 53 grade. So definitely that also you can try. I mean, our engineers, they are using, a lot of them are already using Concrete Plus in the concrete. But whatever strength you are getting in a normal PPC cement available in the market, definitely 20% to 30% higher strength you will get with this cement. So that is concrete.
Yes, sir, definitely. And I'll also means agree with your statement that ACC Concrete Plus is definitely a good kind of cement. If it is being compared to the local market available cement, definitely it is better. I think people should use such kind of cement because it will definitely provide us a proper or workable cement, concrete.
Yeah, thank you, sir. So next question is the concrete grade, does the concrete grade affect on the steel design?
सर अभी देखिए ये सवाल जैसा है ना उसका जवाब भी वैसे ही थोड़ा हल्का है कि हल्का इन द सेंस मुझे उसको थोड़ा मैं सिंप्लीफाइड वे से बताता हूँ. कॉन्क्रीट अगर कॉलम में यूज हो रहा है ना सर, तो कॉलम में यूज होने वाला कॉन्क्रीट हमेशा कॉम्प्रेशन के लिए ही है. उसमें का कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ रिइंफोर्समेंट बहुत कम है. तो उस वक्त अगर हम हायर ग्रेड ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट यूज करेंगे तो मेरा क्रॉस सेक्शन अल्टीमेटली कम होगा ना. अगर मैं सेम टाइम हायर ग्रेड के बजाय अगर हायर ग्रेड स्टील यूज करता हूँ या मोर स्टील उसमें ज्यादा से ज्यादा स्टील उसमें डालने की कोशिश करता हूँ तो इट विल नॉट अफेक्ट. बट सेम टाइम इफ आई एम गोइंग टू इंक्रीज द क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया और प्रोवाइड अ हायर ग्रेड ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट, मेरा कॉन्क्रीट कॉलम बहुत ये हो जाएगा, इकोनॉमिकल वे से होगा.
The next question is from Mr. Sujoy Nanavati. He has a comment that about the anchorage the cross section you talked about, is it specifically written that anchorage should remain within the beam? Can you also share the latest IS code?
And sir, IS code to net pe available hai aur beam ke andar agar aapko fixedity chahiye to your bar should be anchored with the column. That is very simple. Again, this is a part of detailing. In general, statement नहीं कर सकते इसके बारे में. Detailing के हिसाब से बात करनी पड़ेगी.
जी. अच्छा. He has one more comment that requirement of hook in one of your slide you have shown was 6D.
65 mm sir.
65 mm. And in one other slide, I think you are showing some other slide it was 10D. So which one to be followed?
No. 10D plus development length है. कुछ तो मेरे ख्याल से समझने में ये हुआ है. डेवलपमेंट लेंथ प्लस 10.5.
ओके.
हाँ. सो व्हेन इट कम्स अराउंड 50 टाइम्स ऑफ डायमीटर, अल्टीमेटली इट कम्स अराउंड 50 टाइम्स ऑफ डायमीटर.
या हम भी वही बताते हैं सर, 50D
अराउंड उतना ही आता है सर.
सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट ड्यूरेबिलिटी ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट, ये सुनील पाटिल जी का क्वेश्चन है. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट ड्यूरेबिलिटी ऑफ द कॉन्क्रीट, is it only possible by adopting higher grade of concrete more than M25?
Yes sir, because if we are using higher grade of concrete there will be less porous material. आप ही बोलो ना, अगर हम M35 grade का concrete use करते हैं और proper अगर उसको care लेके casting होता है तो उसमें का porosity, उसमें का सारी चीज जो जो क्या बोलते हैं monolithic जो रहेगा वो हमको ज्यादा durable रहेगा ना. M15 में तो वैसे ही सारा भंगिर निकलता था. वो भंगिर जब निकलेगा या हनीकॉम्बिंग निकलेगा तो उसमें कैसे हम ड्यूरेबिलिटी एक्सपेक्ट करेंगे ना.
हाँ, बट इसमें मैं भी एक ऐड करना चाहूंगा सर, बिकॉज़ वी आर आल्सो क्लोजली इन्वॉल्वड इन द कंक्रीट एंड सीमेंट. सो बाय ग्रेड ऑफ कंक्रीट यू आर राइट एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी करेक्ट एंड वेरी रेलेवेंट दैट जनरली द अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज दैट you, if you go on increasing the grade of concrete, your durability will increase.
Yes.
Definitely with grade, durability to certain extent should increase, but grade of concrete, higher grade of concrete will be highly durable. That always doesn't stand true until unless the workmanship is proper.
Yes, you know, sir. Every time. I totally agree with you. Every time. वही तो मैं बोल रहा था सर. सारे प्रेजेंटेशन में मैंने उसी बात पे चर्चा की कि हमारे हार्डल है साइड पे के लोग.
या.
And every time they talks in the terms of experience. हमने किया है. हमने किया है.
उसमें ये हो सकता है सर. And actually we have seen that cases that there is a M25 grade concrete and there is maybe M40 grade concrete, but strength में M40 obviously क्योंकि testing तो हम lab में करते हैं और उसके बाद में जब लेकिन site पर जब हम देख रहे हैं and you know durability is basically it's a long term impact. So हाँ. Porosity you rightly said it is the durability is the function of porosity and permeability.
जी तो
पोरोसिटी एंड परमेबिलिटी का इंपैक्ट आते आते यू नो इट विल टेक सम टाइम सो इफ यू टेस्ट ऑन द परमेबिलिटी एंड पोरोसिटी पार्ट यू नो आरसीपीटी टेस्ट एंड वाटर परमेबिलिटी टेस्ट सो इट हैपेंस मेनी टाइम दैट द हायर ग्रेड कंक्रीट इफ इट इज नॉट अगेन यू नो इफ इट इज नॉट मैन्युफैक्चर्ड प्रॉपरली इट इज नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड प्रॉपरली देन इट मे नॉट बी ड्यूरेबल देन द लोअर ग्रेड कॉन्क्रीट सो एज यू हैव राइटली सेड that with the higher grade of concrete it is also very essential that the concrete you know overall casting and workmanship that is also taken care at the site
yes sir
then only we will get strong as well as durable concrete so one question is from Mr. Sarth so he says that how lift RCC wall to be detailed with beams and columns
to be
lift RCC wall, how it is to be detailed, how its detailing is to be done with beams and columns.
Sir, I don't think, again, this is a very, means, hectic work. It's a very simple kind of joint because your beam is going to be raised over there. If you want to fix it, you can provide proper L or you can remain it as it is if you want to keep it as a simply supported action. So again, it will depend on the scenario. What kind of load is going to be transferred on the lift well?
Okay. So Mr. Sunil Patil is asking that does IS 456 allows to go for mechanical coupling of the reinforcement instead of providing lapping to the bars?
Sir, 456 2000 ka hai. Year 2000 hai uska. अब 13920 2016 का है नाउ यूर 456 इज इन ड्राफ्ट कंडीशन मींस पीपल आर वर्किंग देयर तो नया जब 456 आएगा तो शायद उसमें ये इम्प्लीमेंटेशन आ जाएगा लेकिन अभी जो लेटेस्ट कोड हमारे पास अवेलेबल है 2016 का 13920 इट इज ऑलरेडी परमिटेड टू यू इट इज ऑलरेडी ग्रांटेड कि भाई इसको आपको यूज करना है
I think there is a very long comment from Mr. Pramod Thor that and some question, you know, there is a question also how to achieve ductile reinforcement. How to he is written in the short form ductile reinforcement in stub column or PEB. He is asking for pre-engineered building. The bolt length having 900 mm. The position of bolt and vertical. Running fit. I think it's a very long. I will, sir. I will request you to please post your, you know, give your email ID here.
Sir, it is already written in the last slide.
Okay. So I will request Mr. Pramod to kindly get in touch with.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Mr. Bansode, and he will, you know, because this will be a. I think he has to see in the details and give the answer in detail only.
Sir.
One, two more question more we will take from from Engineer Asif Jamadar. Is joggle in bars at column steel lapping permitted? Also at column beam junction.
Sir, joggle तो अभी हम कर ही रहे हैं. आज तारीख को जो splicing हो रहा है ना, वो joggle के through ही हो रहा है. Otherwise आपका reinforcement बैठ ही नहीं पाएगा. और इसी के लिए अभी मैकेनिकल कपलर हम लोग सजेस्ट कर रहे हैं कि अगर हम मैकेनिकल कपलर यूज करते हैं तो ऑल दोज मींस जो सर्कस चल रही है ना रेनफोर्समेंट के साथ वो खत्म हो जाएगी और हम भी अश्योर्ड होंगे कि हाँ ये जंक्शन वही है, मुझे वो फ्लोर लेवल का जो कंजक्शन ऑफ रेनफोर्समेंट है ना, वहीं पे बीम के बाहर, वहीं पे कॉलम के बाहर, नीचे से आने वाला कॉलम वहीं पे, ऊपर से आने वाला कॉलम वहीं पे, वो सारा थोड़ा बाजू हटाना है तो मुझे ये कॉलम का जंक्शन थोड़ा ऊपर लेके जाना पड़ेगा, और वो अगर ऊपर लेके जाना है तो मैकेनिकल कपलर ज्यादा आसान पड़ते हैं, इवन इन इकोनॉमिकल वे ऑल्सो। अगर मैं 20 mm का बार लेता हूँ सर, तो मेरे 20 mm के बार के लिए मेरा वजन जाता है करीबन 1.6 kg पर रनिंग मीटर। नाउ इंस्टेड ऑफ गिविंग द अमाउंट ऑफ 1.6 kg पर रनिंग मीटर अराउंड से 60-70 rupees, इफ द कपलर इज आई एम गेटिंग इन 50 rupees, व्हाई नॉट टू यूज दैट कपलर। सो अगर हम कपलर यूज करते तो ज्यादा ठीक रहेगा। अरे नो डाउट द जॉगल्स आर बीइंग परमिटेड, एंड उसी तरीके से तो हम डिटेलिंग कर रहे हैं आज।
So I will take last question because now we are running out of time also, sir. And remaining there are lot of questions. I will ask Nilesh to kindly, you know, send all these questions in the chat to Bansoda sir. And also I will request keep the people who are asking these questions to get in touch with Engineer Bansoda. Okay. So. Does the coupler works for splicing the bars in flexural member as the sub are subjected to tension? Will the grip and threads will overcome this tension?
Yes, yes, definitely. ये सभी का question होता है sir. Coupler देखने के बाद हर एक आदमी यही सवाल पूछता है कि ये टिकेगा क्या?
Okay.
There are calculations provided for this coupler. Go with that standard calculation. You will get all those details. But definitely now it is been implemented on site. We people are already implementing such kind of details on our side. So, बिल्कुल दिल में कोई झिझक मत रखिए, इसका एक proper calculation आता है, even जो coupler manufacturer है, वो भी आपको इसके calculation provide करेगा।
Okay sir, fine. I will. Now it's a time to close this session, and I will thank the Ravind Bansoda sir for his nice lecture and the time he has spent with us. And I will also thanks all the participants from the various parts of the region who have participated and spent so much time with us. And I really request all of you to get in touch with Dr. Bansoda. Engineer.
नहीं सर, अभी डॉक्टर नहीं बनाऊं।
मैं आजकल सर जिसके साथ सेशन हो रहा है सबको डॉक्टर बना रहा हूँ, बिकॉज हमारे लिए आप लोग सब जितने कंसल्टेंट्स हैं ऑल आर डॉक्टर्स ओनली, सो यू आर द डॉक्टर्स ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर। So anyway, I thanks everybody here, and we will be continuing this series of webinars on different topics with different experts. So please be in touch. Thank you so much,
sir. Thank you all of you. Thank you. Bye.
Thanks.